face, but early. Mr. AI, do you need any help making travel arrangements for the basketball playoffs?
Oh, no, man. That's cool. You know, the team takes care of all that. Besides, we haven't actually made the playoffs yet,
Of course, you haven't.
Are you okay? Are you winking?
I'm not winking.
No, it's just one eye, man. Look, just relax one eye and just close the other one. Got it?
Yes.
Yeah?
Like that.
No, okay, you're still doing both. It's okay.
All right.
Yeah, keep working on
that. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Like this?
Yeah, you work on that. I'll get this. All right?
No,
keep working.
I do, sir.
All right, man.
All right.
Take care.
I'll work on that.
What are you talking about? We ever made the playoffs? We clinched the playoffs. Look at this cheese. Finally, we are back at home against the Brooklyn Nets, and I can finally rock the city jerseys. I wanted to wait until we get back home at the Staples Center to rock these jerseys.
LeBron James in action tonight. Doesn't always log the same minutes he used to, but Shaq, if the game is close, last 2 minutes, he really puts fear in your heart.
Well, LeBron can't be stopped physically, even at his age. When he's in the zone, there's nothing you can do.
I agree. He can win close games with his offense. Then he can stop you on a defensive end in a close game. He's the most unique guy that can do everything the game possibly has ever seen.
And now we send you to Kevin Harlan. As they get ready for the opening tip.
It's home to Tinseltown and the Lakers, Los Angeles, California, as we bring you an interconference rivalry here at the Staples Center.
Along with our broadcast team and Chris Webber, Greg Anthony and David Aldridge, Kevin Harlan, I hope you'll join us in welcoming our very special guest to the broadcast tonight, the terrific, the legendary Kobe Bryant.
Dude, look at Brooklyn. They're actually in a playoff spot. Position.
Kobe, this is really terrific. Thank you for coming by.
No, I'm always happy to stop by.
The Nets log another stop on their travel schedule. In today's matchup, these guys facing good ball clubs and will continue to over the upcoming stretch of games, even more critical to notch a win in this one.
And right now for the Nets, so much has gone right for them this season. They needed some breaks to go their way, and it feels like they've gotten them all. Now they're poised for success in the playoffs.
They created their own breaks, Greg, I mean, because of how they played throughout the entire season. But now is when things really start to turn.
Yeah, look at these jerseys. I mean, they're not the best. I still like it. It's kind of decent. Look at this. So, it seems like if you rocked, like, the purple jerseys, like, the CPU would rock something else. Like, a classic jersey. I wouldn't mind that.
Teammate with the five championships. Of all the things, the all-star games, the all-defense, all the individual things you've accomplished, what is the one thing you might cherish? And you may have alluded
to, like I said, I wanted to wait until we get back home to rock these jerseys.
At the end of the day, is that the one thing above everything else that you covet?
No. You know, I the fact that I can look in the mirror and honestly say I gave everything to the game.
Right? That was obvious.
That's the thing. Mm-hmm. Right? You don't want to feel like you've left anything on the team. No stone left unturned. I gave everything to the game that I possibly could. That, to me, is the biggest accomplishment.
So the next starting five, Russell and LeBron in the backcourt. Kenneth Faried is out there with Allen, and it's Hollis Jefferson in at the three spot.
So if you guys saw that East standings, yeah, the Brooklyn Nets are actually in a playoff spot.
Up top, Russell. Pass to LeBert. Shot clock at five.
D'Angelo.
I mean, there had to be a better option that time down the court. That's just a missed opportunity.
Yeah, good awareness there. He sees an opening and doesn't hesitate.
Well, that opening right there, that's just because the defense failed to rotate.
Here's Allen after the basket by the Lakers. Pass into LeVert. And there's the call on James. That
plants his first bomb. Just over a minute and a half play here in this one. Russell against James. Lock at six. And they double up Russell. And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up here.
Yeah, I wonder who's going to win this.
And here is Los Angeles now. And so it's Rondo bringing it up for Los Angeles. Just about 2 minutes into the game. First quarter of basketball. Over to the left wing. Let's talk about something that I know fascinates basketball fans, Kobe. Having that competitive streak, which is something that runs deep for you. Talk about the desire to dominate and completely destroy your opponent.
Well, it's the spirit of competition, right? I don't think you're doing anybody any service by going out there and competing half-heartedly. Mm-hmm. Right? If you truly respect the person that you're facing, the right thing to do is to compete as hard as you possibly can against them and bring the best out of them. And that's what both ends of the floor.
Ah, feet on the line.
A one-way dominant player. You can't just compete for the offense and then take it off in the defense. You got to play both sides of the ball.
Your motor never stopped. I mean, that's from our perspective on the sideline watching you play on both ends of the floor, like you said.
Yeah, you got to keep going. And to do that, you have to train really hard all season. Yeah, that's a lot of conditioning. It's a lot of weight training, right? You have to train in extraordinary ways in order to do extraordinary things.
Already one of the league's more creative assist men, Russell, making people around him better.
Nice shot by James.
And you can see when he has the basket in his sights, he's going to attack. And once he's in tight, he is a terrific finisher.
Here's Alice Jefferson. Really played well against Sacramento in his last outing. And it's out of bounds.
Oh, McGee.
Say it was last touch by McGee. First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Lakers lead by four. Nice ball from ahead by the Lakers. Here's James. It is good. The assist from Rondo. James has got his second basket.
And no one can really compete defensively with LeBron's athleticism. I mean, it's just too much to match up.
And it's Rajon Rondo with the foul.
Damn, how are you going to be asking a three?
Here's Fareed. He's no scoreless so far in this one. Russell against LeBron, just 5 on the clock. So it looks like the Knicks will retain possession here. Most of the season completed a good pitcher development as the top rookies in the league.
Now look at those
so
jerseys.
Let's take a look now at the race for Rookie of the Year. While you look at Jay, all season...
I think coming all deep down, what's the best city jerseys this season?
He's the top spot right now, and the hard work...
Can you guess?
And there's no more deserving candidate than any other outcome than him lifting that Rookie of the Year trophy, and I'd be shocked.
Yeah, he's probably separating himself from the pack. I don't know.
We all know that the goddamn Miami Heat by city jerseys is by far the best.
Now you see where the game changes from where it used to be. He said tonight they've got to get back. That means giving up offensive rebounds, so be it. He thinks good transition defense is the biggest difference in their chance of winning. Kevin?
Thank you, David. And stolen by LeBron. And here again, Los Angeles in transition. Up the court they go. The shot's good from James. And it's coming out that AI will be the cover athlete on NBA 2K20. You know, Greg, the kids tell me that this is a big deal.
They need another time.
Play a lot of 2K.
Oh, they scared Brooklyn Nets. Kang, man. They scared.
Curiosity is such a valuable trait in a play. I bet the triangle was a very intriguing offense for you to learn.
They called a timeout like twice and not even in a minute.
People watch jazz musicians orchestrating. It seems as if they're freelancing, but they're freelancing with a built-in structure. You have to have structure in order to be able to freelance and create these amazing things. And the triangle gave unbelievable structure. And you know, some of the people that I've talked to, that have competed against the Triangle and lost against the Triangle, whether it was to us or to the Bulls, all lament about the Triangle, the biggest crock of garbage, just you and Michael. And I said, you know what? Let's have a conversation. You remember this play?
Yeah.
Okay, that play happened at the moment it happened, 2 minutes ago in the fourth quarter, because we knew in the first minute of the game when we ran it, you did this defensively. So we said, okay, they did that. Check. We'll wait. Okay, now let's look at this action. Look at this action, how they throw this action. Look at that one. All right, check. Hold it. Wait. Interesting. Right? And so in the fourth quarter, we're able to take advantage. Why? Right? Because we have a structure. And that structure, you know what you are doing, and you know how to counter what you're doing. Right? There's a reason Michael can look at
Steve. Oh, a spin move.
Be ready.
Damn, that's two fouls on LeBron.
How would he know that unless he knew every time he drove middle, Stockton was coming over to help on his dribble penetration? He could have made that pass to Steve Kerr in the first quarter, second quarter, third quarter. Why did he wait?
There are not many guys entering the league impact their teams this fast. Russell is an exception.
The pass to Jay. The three.
Ah.
So good, and he's 3 for 5. Nets trail by 11. And it's JaVale McGee with the foul. That's his first foul.
And now only one away from being in the penalty.
Los Angeles making a switch here. Ingram's checked in. Here's Russell. Lays it up and banks it in. Russell's got his first basket.
I feel like the only reason why the Brooklyn Nets are in the playoffs is because of D'Angelo Russell. He has the highest overall.
Down low, here's Jay. Another field goal for him. 4 for 6 shooting tonight.
He's been the safety valve for them on every possession. So dependent.
To the wing right side. Allen passes to LeVert. Back to Allen. Pass to Hollis Jefferson. Kobe, I can only imagine the hours you spent studying the legends who came before you, Michael Jordan, and probably other players as well.
Well, yeah, because you have to ask yourself the question is why are these moves that are being executed working?
Right.
It's not good enough just to look at them and say, okay, they work. I'm going to go out and try to do the same thing. That's not good enough. You have to try to understand why they work. And in other situations, why did they
work? I always thought, too, you put your special spin on. You followed this roadmap, but then you took the exit ramp and then put your own spin, own feel on how the move or play.
Well, yeah, because we both had different teams. Right, he had a different cast of characters that he played with. He had a different role, a different responsibility than I had on my team. So I've had to kind of adjust those things in the timing of our games, and when you attack, and when you facilitate, and all those things. The basics of the game remain the same, whether it's myself, whether it's Michael, whether it's Jerry West. You know, those things are all consistent.
A nice shot by LeVert.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with their work down low.
Jay, the pass to Rondo. Pass to Jay. Takes a shot at the elbow. Again, the Lakers.
This is the kind of
start. I know Kobe's on commentary, but you see this, Kobe? I'm looking like you.
Out to the right wing. Russell finds Allen.
And that's already his second foul. He may have to spend some time on the bench to stay out of the foul.
Well, shooting their third and fourth free throw shot to the night.
Looking over their percentage on the season, I think they will be thrilled with the number in terms of their free throw percentage, 79.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles. Beasley comes in for Kyle Kuzma. And Lonzo Ball in for Rajon Rondo. No good from Jay.
He loses concentration at the moment of truth and blows the layup.
To the paint. Here's Davis. That shot off. And the Lakers going the other way now. They traveled to Brooklyn last time they faced the Nets. And they came away with a win.
In the last meeting of these two teams, they were really sharp defensively, disrupting the flow of their offense and causing a ton of turnovers.
And that's what led to a blowout win. Offensively, they were solid, but their defenses were really carried.
Kobe, when you think of that rough and tumble style of the Pistons and the Knicks in the 80s versus this more wide open style, which style do you appreciate more? And which style was more difficult to play?
Well, personally, I always wanted to play in the 80s because of the defensive roles. They made defense roles. You have to play man-to-man.
Yes.
You can't come in 2-9 and paint. There's no zone defenses.
Yeah.
You know, you have to go mano-a-mano. Right? If you go double team,
challenge.
Oh, my gosh. Come on now. People can't hide.
Mm-hmm.
Players can't hide. You know, if a player out there that might not be a good defensive player or doesn't really want to play defense, he can hide. In the 80s, you can't do that.
No hiding.
No, there's no hiding. You're on the island.
Now, here is Davis. 11 points for him in that last game against the Kings in Sacramento. Crab, no good. Los Angeles leading by 12. For the three, and again, it's the Lakers from deep.
And they're getting a lot of their points outside the paint. Three of their last five baskets are from three-point range.
Kicks it to Davis. Back to Crab. Harris outside. Six on the shot clock. And that one off the back of the rim and in. Here's Ball. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Beasley outside. Back to Ball.
I like how we switch.
Well, good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
And good pass.
I like that play.
Setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Here's Dinwiddie. He had 10 points in the win against the Kings in Sacramento.
While he was doing that, I mean, dropping buckets. He was keeping everybody else involved, too. I mean, he had a tremendous night to 17.
There's 1:17 left to play in the first quarter. Ball with it. And looking at his production, he averages a little more than 7 points a game. Jay, the pass to Ingram. And again, it's the Lakers from deep.
And you can't help but pick their defense apart. They're completely in disarray.
52 seconds left to play here in the first. Here's Dinwiddie. Makes it off the glass.
Did anybody see any defensive presence on that player? I mean, he's not going to blow that layup. It was wide open.
There's 45 seconds left to play here in the first. Jay, he's guarded by Clay. Here's Jay, again, Los Angeles.
Boy, has he put his foot on the pedal here this quarter. He's doing a terrific job in terms of leading their offense.
To the left side wing. Here's Dinwiddie. A rebound by the Lakers. McGee's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Pass to Jay. Now, here's Ball. Tight defense on him. Here's Jay. And he was able to put it up in time, but doesn't fall.
Look how Crab uses his lid. Solid to get his hands up to contest these shots.
And a double-digit lead on the scoreboard as we end the first quarter of play. Lakers on top, up by 16. Live from the Staples Center, you're watching 2K Sports.
I'm not going to admit, I see those jerseys. When I saw the on Instagram, I'm like, I don't even like it. But then when I get to see it a lot more in game, I'm like, it's decent now. It's a decent jersey for us. It's not that fire like it was from last year's City jerseys. Oh, I like those jerseys. The black ones, those were just on fire. I think they were the second best next to the Miami Heat by City jerseys.
Well, it's a thin line, especially for scorers, you know, because when you're locked into that mentality, it's very easy. It's almost like a racer. If you race with blinders, you don't see anything else. You have one focus, right? And so it becomes a matter of trying to understand when to attack the opposing game.
It was a good idea to swap right there, LeBron.
Maybe I'll lay back. Or maybe even it's just the first quarter, then close out the first half strong. So you go into halftime with some momentum. But then at the end of the game, you know, that's when you put the blinders back on and you really race for that finish line. And so everything in between just becomes a matter of setting up the pieces so that then you can close the game out the right way. So that's how I felt about it.
and I can sense by the way you described this that you had to know your teammates' game as well as your own game.
Well, yeah, you got to know how they're feeling going into the game.
Yeah.
Right? You this Pau Gasol habit tonight. Yeah. How a little feeling about it. Mm-hmm. Right? You got to be able to measure those things. And, you know, if you feel like the team's going to get off to somewhat of a sluggish start, that's when you kick it into high gear immediately. Right? It's a bit of a guessing game, but it's more so being able to spend the time with your teammates and talk to them. And that'll help you gauge a little bit better.
The 4-5 are the athletic duo of LeBron and McGee. Jay out there with Rajon Rondo, and it's Caldwell Pope at the small forward position. That's the Laker 5. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Jay is right here.
Thanks, David. It was a performance that not many players are capable of.
I know I won't forget it for a while. And you have to think he'll keep it rolling here tonight. When you're that high, it takes a while to pull down.
Yeah, he was special. But the biggest challenge for him tonight is that the defense will be ready for him. They saw what he did in the last game, just like the rest of us.
And so James will bring it up for Los Angeles. 22 is their biggest lead. They host the Kings after this game, and that will be the middle game of this three-game homestand. James has got 15 points.
He's been very solid first quarter. Now he's taking it up a notch here in the second.
Well, Kobe, you're known as one of the greatest Lakers of all time. I know you feel there are a lot of guys in that first line of the sentence, right?
No doubt. Yeah. No doubt. Guys that I've watched growing up. I mean, listen, I go all the way back to the days of Pollard and Mike and I've watched them all.
Jefferson following the basket by LeBron James. Just five to shoot. Shoots from 12. And it's LeVert missing.
Well, he's having a tough go at it so far this quarter. Not much dropping for him.
Jay, the pass to LeBron. To the left wing. Count that one. James has got 13 points now in the quarter.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Russell feeling it out a bit. And the pass to LeVert to the middle. Here's Alex Jefferson. Falls back and drains the fadeaway jumper. 10 points for him.
You know, if you're only looking at the way he's played offensively, you'd think his team would have the lead.
Rondo passes to Jay. Caldwell Pope outside. Off the mark there with a three-point shot. I'd like to give a big thank you once again to Kobe Bryant for coming by, and feel free anytime to drop by and join our broadcast.
Thank you, man. It's been wonderful. Thank you for having me.
You know, Chris, you and Kobe both playing from the same era of the NBA. He was sharing his thoughts about current trends in the league. You feel it's different from when you and Kobe both played?
Oh, definitely. I mean, when you look now, just defensively, when we came into the game, hand-checking was allowed. Then after that, zones were allowed in the game. When we first came in, you think about the three-point line, and the best three-point shooters in the game, maybe we're allowed to take two a game at that time. Now, you see guys, they can let it fly 6 or 7 times, 10 or 12 times, 15 times. So I do think that the game has changed, but I just think that's great because the game has evolved. I love watching where these young players are playing and their skill sets now, and I can't wait to see where the game goes.
Here's Fareed after the made shot from Jay. Not loose. Here we go, James into the hoop.
You have got to be kidding.
Hey, talk about taking things in your own hands. Here's LeVert.
9 points in the game so far. He kicks it to Fareed. Outside, Russell. Pass to Hollis Jefferson. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Rondo. There's 18 seconds left in the first half. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Here's Russell. Rebounded by McGee. McGee's got his 6th rebound on the night. Here's Chang. No good. Second attempt there. And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers holding a very comfortable 25-point lead as the quarter comes to a close.
And the score, I thought, if I would fade on that.
And they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. So far, it has been a runaway. It's been one outstanding game from Jane.
And through the first 2 periods, it seemed he got to the paint whenever he wanted to. Just a slasher's mentality.
Yeah, when you're trying to check a guy like that, you have to move your feet laterally, defensively. That didn't happen.
Third quarter action getting rolling right now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. So for Brooklyn now, Russell and LeVert in the backcourt. Hollis Jefferson is out there with Kenneth Fareed. And it's Allen in at the pivot spot, manning the middle.
Good movement there. And the lead pass was right where it needed to be.
Chris, of current players who could eventually become coaches, who would you put in that category? A lot of brilliant guys have played this game, think the game through so well.
Chris Paul, Ariza, those guys come to mind for some reason to me. Klay Thompson,
yes,
comes to mind. And I don't know if it's the personality that I see these guys in, or if it's the way that they approach the game, but those guys come to mind. I definitely can see them taking the game to another level once they're playing days of injury.
And just showing great vision there, Russell surveys the floor and whips it to the open man.
James outside. And he makes that one. LeBron's got 21.
And defensively, 21. This is the opposite of how you want to start the second half.
Yeah, I mean, you spend all that time in the locker room trying to get mentally prepared, then you come out and give up that? No.
And stolen by James. Jay, the pass to James. Knocked away. And we're just around 2 minutes into the final half of play now. Russell kicks to Allen, pass to Hollis Jefferson. The Nets working the ball around now. Here's LeVert, James covering, and it's Rajon Rondo at the bottom. That's his 3rd foul of the game. So for the Nets, Harris comes in for Hollis Jefferson, and Spencer Dinwiddie subbed in for LeVert. It's Allen on the wing, guarded by McGee. 6 to shoot. Dinwiddie passes to Fareed. Makes it off the glass. Fareed's got 8.
That makes 3 in a row to start the second half.
Lakers leading by 20. Passes it to Jay. Rondo scanning the floor. Down low, James. That's good, coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. 23 points for LeBron.
James is used to scoring through contact. Doesn't matter what the D throws out.
Timeout called. The Nets, without question, Jay displaying his skills today.
Since the All-Star break, he has been superb. How about 44 points per, 7 assists and 4 rebounds? And he's been putting up points with regularity. I mean, that's what they depend on, his killer instinct on offense.
Yeah, anytime this club needs a basket, he's their go-to guy. Just an irrepressible, prolific scorer.
Russell Noah.
His effort level is there. You can't blame him on that. He's working to get good shots. He's just not connected.
The defense there got away with a major lapse.
Here's the floater. Dinwiddie with the bucket. He's got 9.
Oh, look at the soft touch on the teardrop.
Lakers leading by 20. The pass to Jay. Kicks to McGee. pass to James. Buries it down low. James has got 6 points in the quarter. Here's Russell checking some stats on him right now. He's averaging just around 22.5 points a game. Knocks it loose. Dinwiddie passes to Russell. Here's Dinwiddie. He's covered by Ball. Back to Russell. Six to shoot. Over LeBron. And again, it's Brooklyn converted.
Yeah, with the size and quick shot.
3 of 11, D'Angelo Russell.
Cover from mid-range.
LeBron James on the wing. Pass to Jay. It's James atop the key. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. The Lakers have not shot all that well from the free throw line. 6 of 11. And he makes the first. And Los Angeles with some changes. Los Angeles leading by 19. Inside, we've got Kuzma and McGee. Rajon Rondo is out there with Jay, and it's Hart in at the three. That's the Laker five.
And low percentage look on that one. Not sure what he was thinking. But sometimes you get a little outside of yourself. You have to be a little more disciplined.
Passes it to Jay.
He does all the little things. I mean, he does the big things. I mean, he's got them in front with another outstanding performance.
Here's Dinwiddie, and there's the pass to LeVert. Here's Alice Jefferson.
Oh!
Let's go home. That was just ridiculous.
I do not remember the last time I saw a dunk like that in a game. And a terrific bit of chaos there on the replay, presented by the Under Armour Hover Habit. Now, here's Kuzma. Here's LeVert. That one falls, coming off Dinwiddie's feet. Dinwiddie's got his 7th assist of the game with that last one. Pass to Jay. Back to Rondo. Shoot from the right block. And they pick up 2. And the Lakers lead by 19.
And, you know, he's proven to be capable at sinking that mid-range jump shot. Rondo has to be respected from that part of the floor.
Here's LeVert. The teardrop falls in. LeVert's got 4 points this quarter.
Now how about how he sets his man up there, runs it right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
Rondo passes to Jay. Inside, and Kuzma swings it in.
Oh, the ability of Kuzma coming into play there, outstanding at setting good screens and rolling fast.
Here's Dinwiddie. Just under 2.5 minutes gone here in the final quarter. Pass to LeVert. A rebound by the Lakers. Earlier in the game, they held a 25-point lead. Jay, he's guarded by Crabb. Kicks to Rondo. Passes it to Jay. Lakers passing it around. Inside.
Oh! Well, you gotta respect the awareness level.
Take off Josh Hart's picture. It shows the black city jerseys. It still shows that. They didn't even update his picture.
Here's Dinwiddie and the best, Alice Jefferson.
I wish we had a word rock.
Each team has one inactive player per night. Would upping that amount, you think, C-Web, of active players on game day change anything at all?
I don't believe so, because the inactive player we're talking about usually is at the bottom of the roster, and so if you look at the next man up there, that means that the last guy on the bench at that time, it's his time to get that playing time. So I don't think that the inactive players would change anything because it's still a team sport, and those guys earn their playing time.
Oh, and we're just dunking, okay?
He's still one of the greatest players in the world and can contribute at any time.
And the one hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish. Jay, he's guarded by Cram. Outside for Rondo. Let's it go with a three. Rebounded by the Nets. Hollis Jefferson's got his fourth rebound in this one. Now here's Cram. He's covered by Rondo. Tipped away. And now here's Rondo, the fast break opportunity. Jay, the pass to Rondo. Down low, here's McGee, and Davis sends it back, and he gets it back. Five to shoot. Los Angeles needs to get off a shot here. The shot's good from McGee.
Indicative of what we've seen tonight, one team being the aggressor, the other failing to react.
You know the saying, numbers don't lie. You can see it up there on the scoreboard.
Hollis Jefferson passes to Dinwiddie. Davis against McGee. The feed to Dinwiddie. Down goes basket number six for him this game. He's taken 12 shots and made half of them.
I can't find a much better shot in Dallas.
Now here's Rondo. T right on him. Pass to Hart. To the inside. And he jams it with authority.
And a pretty screen set for him that time. And he doesn't fool around. Just straight to the rim.
No way for his man to get around that one, that's for sure.
And that's the play they'll run over and over, fellas, as long as he keeps working.
Brooklyn with the ball, after the basket by Los Angeles. Basket in with it. Three-pointer, and the Nets, another three.
Wow, something's brewing, guys. The three-pointers just continue to flow.
Jay, he's guarded by Cram. See, Rev, when you look at how basketball is taught at early levels for these kids, middle school and then high school, anything there that you would change?
Yes, I would change to developing all players and taking away positions. When you were young, let's say third grade, and you're the tallest player on the team, and I make you a center, and I pull you to one hand, and I only show you how to make layups. I don't show you how to shoot threes or the dribble. Body's always going to stay the same. I believe that coaches should teach great skill sets this whole time. I think that really what you need to do is teach full skill sets.
Now, LeBron is the player of the game, huh?
Someone would have said, Kevin Durant, you can only shoot layups. We wouldn't be able to see the true unicorn that he is.
Well, this time we got to show it up.
Los Angeles making a switch here. James has checked in. And then for Brooklyn, Allen's checked in for Davis. And for Reeds, subbed in for Graham. Lakers leading by 20. Now Rondo passes it to Kuzma. Jay, the pass to James. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. James has got 11 in the second half.
Strong work for him at the offensive end, helping them to maintain that lead.
Dinwiddie, he's covered by Rondo. And it's Levert missing.
A slight rebound advantage for them. One more column in their favor, and it's all adding up. Really nice job to convert the putback opportunity there. I mean, he stayed with that play from start to finish. That's something we see about him a lot. And he doesn't just go to the reverse. He goes to the double clutch reverse.
You've got to have guts to try that move. Here's Dinwiddie, and kicks it to Free. And it's the Lakers on the break. A three, and another three for the Lakers.
Wow, unconscious has he been this quarter. They're riding that hot hand.
Brooklyn's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. James Dinwiddie. He's covered by Rondo. Compared to when you were playing C-Web, how have the baseline skill requirements for the fours and the fives, the power forwards and the centers, changed, you think, the most?
The ability to stretch the floor. A lot more emphasis on the mobility.
The best of Eastman. Second chance effort, and the layup is up and in.
Tough effort right there on the glass. Those second chance points can pay off in a big way.
Ball against Russell, and the call will be against Lonzo Ball. That's foul number two for him. Kenneth Faried, he's checked in for Dinwiddie. Reed inside, out of bounds. Next ball is Brooklyn Beach possession. The Nets making a switch here. Hollis Jefferson's checked in. Here's Faried over Beasley. And again, it's the Nets missing. The pass to Jay. The three, and another three for the Lakers.
Liking the vision there from Caldwell Pope, looking to get his guys going when they're open.
Now, here is Russell, and Jay gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul. There's 1:38 left in the game. Harris finds Hollis Jefferson. Slammed home, and he draws the foul chance for another point at the free throw line. That was on Beasley.
Oh, fellas, that was a vicious two-hand monster slam.
Guys, I don't think there was anyone who could have stopped him on that one. LA is on 3 or 4 from downtown here in the fourth.
And as we head to the final buzzer here, a crushing blowout. Big-time dominance, and this will go in the record books as a galley win for the Lakers.
I'm a double-double.
There were some dominant moments in there about every facet of this game for that team.
Yeah, I mean, Kevin, it's hard to think of what didn't go right for them. Game planning by the coaches, execution by the players, everything was just on target.
And what's been a tremendous year tonight, another example, and they'll push their amazing win total on the season to 68. An outstanding, outstanding season we watched this team play.
A two-game season series. They win them both and complete the sweep.
And you know, looking back at all the contributions tonight, it was a really phenomenal all-around game for Jay.
Well, he's the agitator, bothering everybody with his defense, coming up with steals, making sure they were never able to get comfortable as long as he's on the floor. And for D'Angelo Russell, the former number two pick, it's all about developing himself as a player and a leader. Has focused more on the team and less on himself of late, and knows what is expected of him and has to earn every second of floor time.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles. James checked in for Beasley. Lance Stevenson subbed in for Caldwell Pope. LeBron outside. Shot clock at 6. And another basket for the Lakers.
And giving the fans what they came to see, a spirited performance. Yeah, with a double digit lead at this point, they can pretty much mark this one up in the win column.
Harris picks for Russell. Yep, it counts. That gives him the double double. 10 points and 11 assists.
Feeling out the pick and roll, Russell never looks like he's in a hurry.
Fades off on. So it's Los Angeles doing this one easier. And the outcome of this
one. Wasn't even that close. 134-106. That means Brooklyn, man.
Right?
I mean, yes, they are in a playoff spot, but who's the better team?
And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Chris Webber, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA. Presented by 2K Sports. See you later.
LeBron did not get a triple-double again, but he got 11 assists, so that's why he's the player of the game. But we both got double-doubles.